Yeah, good morning, dear students. We are in module 4, that is input tax credit. So here topics to be covered from the introduction and meaning till deemed registration. We have discussed in our previous session. So in today's session or in today's class, we'll mainly concentrate on remaining aspect, that is return under GST, furnishing of return, first return, revision of return and penalty or late fees. So in that, the furnishing of returns or types of return is very, very important from exam point of view. So we'll concentrate the remaining concepts so that we are finishing the module 4 theory part. In module 4 only theory we have, that we are finishing today. So next week I will start the module 5. So module 5 is a combination of theory and problem. So theory part I will cover first, then I will finish module 6. Then we'll concentrate on problems. Yeah. So today's concept, we will begin with the returns under GST. What do you mean by returns under GST? See, we have returns in tax. Return file is a common word or common usage in all types of tax. Even income tax also, we have the concept of return file, because every assessee, he need to file his return. That means he has to show his income to the government in various forms. Like in income tax, we have many types of return filing we can do. So ITR 1, ITR 2, ITR 3, ITR 5, like that. Many return filing option is there in income tax. Same thing under GST also, we have various types of return or various types of furnishing the returns. So that we will discuss. Before going to the types of return under types of returns under GST, we'll see what do you mean by exactly returns under GST. So every registered person paying a GST is required to furnish an electronic return every calendar month. So whoever tax person is paying GST, he is required to furnish an electronic return. It is a compulsory. Even income tax also, filing a return is compulsory for every SSE. So here under GST, every registered person who is paying GST is required to furnish an electronic return every calendar month. That means for every businessman, for each month transaction, he has to file a return in the subsequent month. That means every month he has to file a electronic returns under GST. So GST return is a document that will contain all the details of your sales, purchase, tax collected on sales and tax paid on purchases, nothing but input tax. All the details he has to show in this GST return. It is a document. So that will show, because GST is applicable mainly for the businessman. So that will contain all the details of your sales, purchase and whatever the tax collected from the customer and whatever the tax paid on the purchase, that is input tax. Everything we have to show the details under returns under GST. Once you file the GST returns, you will need to pay the resulting tax liability. Once you file the return, GST return, then you have to pay as a businessman, as a registered person, you have to pay the tax liability, that is money that you owe to the government. So how much money is pending to the government in the form of GST, that amount you have to pay to the government immediately after the filing of GST returns. Then due date for filing the GST returns. Here option is there. Suppose if your annual turnover is up to 1.5 crore, you can opt for quarterly filing return. Actually, every month you have to file a return, but if your annual turnover is up to 1.5 crores, then you can opt for a quarterly filing return. You can opt for quarterly filing return. So once in a quarter, for example, January, February month transaction, you have to file a return maybe in the month of April. That means for every quarter, subsequent month, you have to file a return. And annual turnover more than 1.5 crore means you must file monthly. Every month you have to file a return. Example I also given for quarterly January to March transaction before April 30th, you have to file a return. For if the turnover is exceeding 1.5 crore, then for example, March month transaction, you have to file a return before 10th, that is maybe due date is 11th April 2019. So every subsequent month, before 10th of the subsequent month, you have to file a return. That is the due date for filing the GST return. One is quarterly return, another one is monthly return. Then under GST, a registered dealer has to file GST returns. So under GST returns, already we have seen, we have to include the details of purchase, you have to include the details of sales, you have to include the details of tax collected from the customer, and you have to include the details of tax paid on purchases, nothing but input tax. So under GST, a registered dealer has to file a GST return that include inward supplies, that is nothing but purchases, outward supplies, that is nothing but sales, then output GST, nothing but the tax collected from the customer, that is the output GST, input tax credit, nothing but GST paid on purchases. All the details you have to show under GST returns. Then all business owners and dealers who have registered under GST compulsorily have to file GST returns according to the nature of the business or the transactions. So every businessman or owners or dealers who have registered under GST means they have to file a return, maybe a monthly return, maybe a quarterly return, they have to file. Then furnishing of a return. Furnishing of return is nothing but the returns that electronically, they have to file a return electronically through the common portal. So return can be filed by using the following methods. GSTN portal, that is goods and service tax network portal is there, that you can log in, and in this common portal you can file a return. Or offline utilities provided by GSTs, there also you can file a return. And GST Suvidha providers, these are all the consultancy agency, maybe there you can file the GST return, if not online. So furnishing of returns or types of returns, very important. We have many types of return under GST, like how we have types of return under income tax, the same manner we have many types of returns under GST also. So I will give you the GST return forms as well as for which purpose it is used. This one you can take it as a side heading. The detailed explanation I have included in my notes, as well as so that notes, PDF file of that particular notes, I will share with you in Monday's class. So that time, detailed explanation you can go through, or you can refer slide also. So in that slide also, little bit explanation I have included. So various types of returns we have, GSTR1, GSTR2, that is used for various purposes. GSTR1 is used for return for outward supplies. GSTR2 is used for inward supplies. GSTR2A is the read-only document. GSTR3B is a summary of both inward and outward supplies. GSTR4 is a composition dealer, that is written for composition dealer, the person who opt for composition scheme, especially for the small taxpayers, so that they can use GSTR4 returns. Then GSTR5 is for a foreign non-resident taxable person. Then GSTR6 for input service distributor, that is ISD. GSTR7 is for taxpayer deducting the TDS. GSTR8 is for e-commerce operator collecting TCS. GSTR9 is annual return for normal registered taxpayer under GST. GSTR9A is nothing but annual return for composition dealers. 9B is annual return for e-commerce operator. 9C is return for registered person getting accounts audited from chartered accountant. That is applicable only for the turnover exceed rupees 2 crores in a financial year, applicable for the tax person or a registered person whose turnover is exceeding 2 crores in a financial year. For them, GSTR 9C form is applicable. GSTR 10 is nothing but return for registered person whose GST registration get cancelled. Whoever registered person registration gets cancelled means they have to file a return under GSTR 10. And finally, we have GSTR 11, that is written for UIN, that is the unique identification number holders. They have to file a return under GSTR 11 form. So these are all various types of GST return or furnishing of returns. further classification I have given types of return filled by or filed by normal taxpayers, that is GSTR 1, GSTR 2A, GSTR 3 and GSTR 9, it is filled by normal taxpayer or normal registered person under GST. Types of returns filled by composition taxpayer, that is whoever opt for composition scheme, especially for the small taxpayer whose turnover is less than 1.5 crores, they can opt for composition tax scheme. Their GST tax rate may be a lesser. We have seen the complete explanation for composition tax scheme, maybe under module 1 as well as module 2. We have gone through the detailed explanation about the composition tax scheme. For composition taxpayers, GST 4A, GSTR 4, GSTR 9A form is applicable, and types of return filled by tax deductor, GSTR 7 and GSTR 7A is applicable, and types of return filed by e-commerce operator, GSTR 8, GSTR 9B, GSTR 10 form is applicable. And types of return filed by foreign non-resident taxpayer, GSTR 5 is applicable, and input service distributor, GSTR 6 and GSTR 6A is applicable. So that types of return or furnishing of returns, detail side heading you can write, and explanation part you can refer this also, because due date I have included for all the types of return, and detailed explanation also I have included in my complete notes. You kindly go through. So one by one, see GST 1 side heading, you can refer the slide, and it is for inward outward supplies. Monthly return they have to do. Every due date is 10th of the subsequent month or next month. GSTR 2 is for inward supplies, monthly 15th of the next month. Side heading I have given in the previous slide, that you can refer. GSTR 3 is for both outward and inward supplies, maybe a monthly, 20th of the next month is the due date. So like that, for everything I have included the explanation part as well as due date. Kindly go through. This one explanation is not required, as it is you need to present if it is asked for the exam. See, all the types of returns, especially the GSTR forms, I have included, as well as due date also I have included. So kindly go through. For the detailed explanation, you can refer the PDF file. Then first return. What do you mean by first return? Very simple. First return means immediately after the registration, registered person is filing a return, means that is called as first return. So that is as per the section 40 of the CGST Act 2017. Every registered person who had made outward supplies in the period, that is between the date on which he become liable to registration till the date on which registration has been granted. So between the date of he became liable to registration as well as till he get the registration certificate, he declared the same in the first return furnished by him after the grant of registration. So once he get the registration certificate, whatever he files the return, that return is called as a first return furnished by registered person under the section 40 of the CGST Act 2017. Then revision of returns. The mechanism of filing revised returns for any corrections of errors, omissions has been done away with. So any omission, any error you made or committed at the time of filing the return, means you can revise your return anytime. That rectification of errors or revising the returns can be allowed in the subsequent returns. Suppose January month you file a return in the month of February. Suppose you have found out any mistake or omission or errors you found out, means in the subsequent return, maybe in the February month return, you can rectify that mistake. That is called as revision of returns. However, no rectification is allowed after furnishing the return for the month of September, that is for the annual return due date for the annual filing returns. That is after the month of September, you are not allowed to do any rectification or revision of return is not possible. Then last slide for today's class, or last slide for the module 4, the penalty and late fees. So it is compulsory for all the registered person to file a return. As per the GST Act, late fees is rupees 100 per day. suppose if you are not filing a return, means late fee is 100 per day is applicable as per the GST Act. So it is 100 under CGST as well as 100 under SGST. So total 200 rupees per day minimum is applicable for 200 per day is late fee or penalty is applicable for a registered person, maximum of 5,000. There is no late fees for IGST. There is a late fees for CGST. There is a late fees for SGST. But for IGST, there is no late fees. So interest is 18% per annum along with the penalty or late fees. Interest of 18% per annum is applicable for the amount of outstanding tax to be paid. Suppose 10,000 GST amount is pending, means on the 10,000, 18% interest is calculated per annum. That amount also you have to pay along with the late fees as a penalty. So late fees for filing GSTR 1, GSTR 3B, GSTR 4, GSTR 5 and GSTR 6 after the due date has been reduced to rupees 50 per day. Earlier it was 100 rupees, later on it was reduced to 50 per day. Not applicable for all types of return, applicable for these returns, that is GSTR 1, GSTR 3B, GSTR 4 and GSTR 5 and 6. Then late fees for filing nil returns. For example, few registered person or few taxable person, they are supplying the goods or services which are having nil returns or exempted goods or services. They are supplying, means for them tax liability is not applicable, but still it is the duty of them to file a returns. For them, if they are filing the return late also, for them, late fees for filing the nil return have been reduced to rupees 20. For them, only 20 rupees per day late fees is applicable. Those who are filing the return for the nil tax rate, that is having nil tax liability for the month, for them tax liability is not there. They don't have to pay any tax to the government, but still they have to file a return. Before the due date, if they are not filing the return, late fees is only 20 rupees per day is applicable. This is all about penalty as well as late fees. So here we come to an end of module 4. Any doubt you have, means you can clarify maybe in the Google classroom or as well as in the WhatsApp group. You can clarify, go through the audio clips as well as video clips which I have shared of my online class. So any doubt you have, means feel free to ask anytime relating to module 4, that is input tax credit. So in Monday's class, I will share you the complete notes, PPT, PDF file, both complete detailed explanation of the notes I will share in my Monday's class. So kindly go through, read for the exam. Meanwhile, stay home and stay safe. Stay home and keep learning every time. Thank you very much. Meet you in the next class, that is in the next week. Thank you very much. Take care of your health.